Hi, I'm Luca. And until an hour ago, I thought Spain was a weird way to pronounce pain. How? Don't ask. Welcome to our cooking show. Hello, and welcome back to our cooking show. And in this episode, we'll be cooking a famous Spanish delicacy known as the churros. Yes, and I'm told it isn't a simple recipe either. Apparently, the cooking part is particularly difficult, which is why the crew is wearing Kevlar suits and the firemen are on speed dial. Let's get started, shall we? Right, we've got everything ready, the ingredients and the equipment, I hope. Here's the bowl for the cinnamon sugar coating, the other bowl for the churros. Churros, thank you. We've got the ingredients as well, the chocolate for the chocolate sauce, the salt, the sugar, the baking powder, the olive oil, the plain flour, and more sugar? We've ran out of cinnamon. Right, we're all set. Let's get started then, shall we? Thank you. So, start off by combining the sugar and cinnamon in a third separate bowl. Do you have a third separate bowl? 1 minute. I need this from Studio 5. Ah, brilliant. Just empty whatever that is in the sink and let's finally get started. I think there's still some inside. It'll be fine, just hurry up, we've got to get started. Right, so the 46 grams of sugar's in there. Wait, why did we do that? We're not even mixing it with the cinnamon. Let's just swiftly move on to step 2. So, we'll mix the flour, baking powder, and salt in a bowl. Right, so 125 grams of flour's in. Could you remind me how much baking powder I need? Right, so you're going to need 0.83 tablespoons of baking powder. Right, 0.85 of a tablespoon of... So that's... Hang on. Less than 1 tablespoon of baking powder. 85% of a tablespoon of... I best just take these instructions with a pinch of salt. Get out. Something just doesn't feel right about mixing this. Right, so we're going to add 416.67 milliliters of vegetable or canola. Hang on a minute, this is for frying. Right, I got it. It's 0.83 milliliters. No, hang on. Right, so it's 0.83 tablespoons of vegetable canola or olive oil. But make sure it's not extra virgin olive oil. God, thank God I got that right finally. You got that all down, I hope, right? Yes. Yes, I did. Right. Right. 0.83 of a tablespoon, so that's 83% of a tablespoon.
This is not a tablespoon!
What? But then what do I measure my baking powder with? move on. Disappears. Right, so that's done. What's next? Right, so next you've got to add 208.33 millilitres of boiling water. You didn't expect to see the kettle in this episode, did you? Turtle. Turtle.
Do you need cinnamon?
We don't have cinnamon.
We have plenty of cinnamon.
My God, you must be blind.
So are you judging? You're the one with glasses.
You've got glasses too.
Yeah, but I don't need them. Turtle.
Right. Time to add 1.67 tablespoons of cinnamon to the sugar that's in the Erlenmeyer flask and mix well. And that's a sentence I didn't think I'd say today. Oh no. Inconclusive. How did I reach this point in my life? Is it mixed? No, it's not. Yeah, no, it isn't. Right, so we've added the 208.33 millilitres of boiling water, and we're currently mixing it until it becomes a thick, gummy batter, in which case it's ready to be cooked. Oh, good. You done? Good. So, next step is to put everything inside a piping bag and prepare to cook. Good luck!
What?
Now, brace yourselves for a lot of here's what we prepared earlier, because the next bit is a bit of a race against time. So, here's a thing. It's not a latex glove, okay? It's the other thing we were talking about earlier. Bag that we prepared earlier. I'm gonna need a spoon. I now have acquired a spoon. So, oh Jesus. Oh my God. I hope you've got a book, because you'll need one. God, I shouldn't have said this is a race against time. Anyway, let's move on to the cooking. Right, so here everything is ready. We've got the thing with the stuff. We've got the oil heated to 170 degrees in the pan. We've got the sugar and cinnamon, which is all ready to have the churros straight from the pan put in there. We've got the plate ready so that we can transfer those in there. The lawyers have not been warned, the directors have made their will, the chef has lost faith in me, and my assistant has a fire extinguisher, so I guess we're all set. Let's get started. Welcome back! Don't mind the dinner cooking there, please. I'm hoping it turns out okay. That'll be in a future show. So, the churros are complete. All of them were definitely done by me. We had an extra step, by the way. We realised that
it might not be a wise idea to have all of the churros inside the sugar and cinnamon while they were still oily from the oil in the pan. So we added this step, which is basically some paper towels on a plate, which would suck up all the oil and therefore better churros. So now that the churros are complete, it's time to begin the chocolate sauce. Right, so the chocolate sauce, an also fairly important part of eating churros. For this, you're going to need two ingredients. This tasteless chocolate, which is mostly cocoa, which is a shame because I quite like eating this on its own. Are you mad? So, right, for this recipe you'll need this tasteless chocolate, well, tasteless, this 70% cocoa chocolate, which should only be used for cooking, honestly, and some heavy cream, which I can only assume is a fancy way of saying creme fraiche. So what do we need to do? Right, we need to place the chocolate and the heavy cream in a heatproof bowl and microwave in 30 second bursts, stirring in between until it's smooth.
For God's sake, please, it's called creme fraiche.
How many grams of chocolate? 83.33 grams of dark chocolate. Get it right, eh? Get it right. We want exactly 83.33. If you get it off by even 0.001 grams, the chocolate's ruined, okay? The chocolate is ruined. You got the balance wrong. And if you ruin the chocolate, you've ruined the churros. Okay, so no pressure. No pressure. Anyway, want some? This has got to be the first time I measure creme fraiche in millilitres. Careful now, you want to get the balance just right. You got to get it exactly. Oh, jeez! Difficult recipe, but simple at its heart. Completed just in time for dessert and for the camera's battery life to die. So, on that note, it's time to end. Thank you for watching, and I hope we don't set fire to the house next time.